Hey, what's up? I'm Chris Ellinas and welcome to the first episode of Fasting 5, where I share fast-paced tutorials, tips and tricks around design in 5 minutes or less. I know that it sounds weird, how can colors help you work faster? But there is a specific feature in some of the Adobe apps that help you do exactly that. Before I get started with the video, I want to thank you for your warm response on the first video I made. I didn't expect that, so yeah, thank you very much. So as I was saying, it's not the actual colors that help you work faster, but the fact that they make your whole process more organized visually. So let's set the clock, I will show you how to use them in every app, and then I will explain the benefits of using colored labels and how I personally use them. In order to color code in Photoshop, just right click on the layer and pick the color you want from the menu. You can do that in multiple layers or on groups to color code all the layers included. You can also instantly do it if you're creating a new layer by holding the Alt key and click on the new layer icon. Name it and pick a color. Bonus tip, in Photoshop you can filter your layers by clicking the icons on the top of the panel. And from the drop-down you can change it to colors and then pick the color you want. In Premiere Pro, right-click to the file either on your project panel or directly on your timeline, choose Label and pick a color. But before you do that, in After Effects and Premiere Pro, there is an awesome ability that you don't have in Photoshop. Go to Edit, Preferences, Labels, and there you can change the name and the color of your label. You can also set some label defaults so you can work even faster. Also on your timeline, you can right-click, go to Label, select Label Group to select the same kind of files. In this timeline, for example, the narrative, music, sound effects and all the audio files are all over the place. By using this method, I can quickly arrange them in separate tracks. You can also go to Edit, Keyboard Shortcuts and type Label. Create your own shortcuts, and now you can label things even faster. I also suggest that you go to File, Project Settings, General, and check the box on the bottom. This way, when you change a label in the project panel, it will also change on the timeline. Pretty similar stuff in After Effects, but instead of right-clicking on the file to choose a layer, click on the small box in front of the name. Go to Edit, Preferences, Layers. Name the layer, change the color and set your defaults. When you have projects with many files and many layers and you are just starting out or you're not familiar with the software yet, those could look pretty intimidating and overwhelming. Visually organizing can help you identify and find really quick what you're looking for. Imagine that you're searching for the second B-roll in this timeline. Will it be easier to do it this way where all the colors are the same, or this way where you know that it's the yellow one in the center? The seconds that you're losing every time you're searching for a file can quickly add up in minutes and hours. Can you calculate how many hours you're losing every year just searching for a file? What I like to do is to stay consistent on the color that I use, depending on the kind of the file. This way, even if I open up an old project, just by looking on the layers or timeline, I already know where everything is. Using the exact same colors is also very convenient if multiple people are working on the same project. So, for example, let's say another member of the team wants to edit one of my PSD files. If we color code the Greek title related files always blue, then it's really easy and fast to find them. Maybe it sounds counterintuitive that in order to speed up your process, you need to spend time labeling things, but now that I'm doing it every time, I'm color coding without thinking about it. It's like an automatic response every time I bring a new file into the project. If you want me to make a video about how I organize my files for editing, let me know in the comments below. Finally, even if you don't want to add color on your layers, that's totally fine. But remember to add some color in your life.